بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. الله says in سورة الحديد: آمنوا بالله ورسوله وأنفقوا مما جعلكم مستخلفين فيه. Allah tells us to believe in Allah and His Messenger. آمنوا بالله ورسوله. Allah tells us, Allah, you could even say commands us. Allah tells us to believe in Allah and His Messenger. وَأَنْفِقُوا مِمَّا جَعَلَكُمْ مُسْتَخْلَفِينَ فِيهِ. And to give in charity from what we have entrusted you with temporarily. Allah is reminding us that anything that we have in reality is not from us, it's from Allah. And we're just a medium. Allah has entrusted us with whatever blessings we have, whatever money a person may have, whatever wealth a person may have. Allah is reminding us that we're just a bus stop. We're just a train station, right? That wealth, that money, that blessing, Allah gives it to us. We have it for a very short period of time, and then we move on. So Allah is reminding us within the few moments that we have in this life, Allah is telling us one of the keys as it relates to taking advantage of the opportunity of this life to attain Allah's pleasure, to come closer to Allah Azza wa Jal. Allah tells us about iman, and then Allah gives us an action item. How many times in the Quran does Allah say, "Alladhina amanu wa amilu salihat," those who believe and they do righteous deeds? Allah reminds us time and time again the importance of living our faith. The claim is one thing. Talking the talk is one thing. That has its time and its place. That's understood. But Allah is telling us, don't just talk the talk, but more importantly, walk the walk. Allah mentions here faith. آمنوا بالله ورسوله وأنفقوا مما جعلكم مستخلفين فيه. Allah tells us, believe in Allah and His Messenger. Now, what's a key sign that I really believe in Allah and His Messenger? What's the proof of that? To give in charity. وأنفقوا مما جعلكم مستخلفين فيه. And within this, Allah is reminding us that anything we have ultimately is from Allah. So during the few moments that we have, what can we do to show Allah that we want to end up in paradise forever and ever and ever? خَالِدِينَ فِيهَا أَبَدًا. One of the key ways to do this is to give in charity, to give to any noble cause. So I encourage you here and now to give something in charity tonight. It could be any amount. You know, you choose the noble cause or organization, whatever it may be. Just give something tonight. Give something tonight, trusting that Allah will give you so much more in return. But Allah tells us that it's on us, the onus is on us. We have to walk towards Him and He'll run towards us. We have to do our part first, and Allah will do so much more for us in return. But are we willing to take that step towards Him? Allah tells us a key step to take if we're serious about wanting to come towards Him, to give in charity from what we have been entrusted with temporarily. There's a lot contained within that. We ask Allah to make us people of charity. We ask Allah to guide us and forgive us. We ask Allah to turn all of our hardships into ease. And we ask Allah to relieve any and all of the worries that we all have. These are times of anxiety. These are times of struggle and hardship. We ask Allah to alleviate all of us from all of these things and to turn the darkness into light. Amin Rabbil Alameen. فَإِنَّ مَعَ الْعُسْرِ يُسْرًا. إِنَّ مَعَ الْعُسْرِ يُسْرًا. Allah reminds us that with hardship comes ease. With hardship comes ease. We ask Allah for that ease and to alleviate the hardship from us. Amin Rabbil Alameen. Wa akhiru da'wana and alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen.